Hello students, today we are going to solve question answers, or we can say doubts, of the topic crop production and management. As this is the very first topic, I would like to tell over here, first of all we are going to discuss the question answers and the objectives or MCQs, whatever is given in NCERT. Okay, and after that we will be solving some extra questions also. And when we talk about NCERT, first of all we are going to discuss with the keywords. Now actually keywords are something like, if you are thorough with the keywords, if you understand the keywords properly, it means you are quite comfortable with the chapter also. While discussing the keywords, you will also find that there are some words which is very difficult to define, but it doesn't matter. Like if we understand, if we know the things, then even we should be able to write it, isn't it? We should be able to define it. So to start with, we are going to begin with NCERT, and in NCERT solution, first of all we are going to discuss with the keywords. Okay, so first of all we are going to talk about keywords. Okay, now first keyword which is given over here is agriculture practice. The first keyword which is given over here is agricultural practice. Okay, let me write this, agricultural practice. Okay, now when we talk about agriculture practice, see, we have discussed this thing in the topic, and we all know that before sowing the crop, before sowing the seeds in the field, okay, there is certain preparation which has to be done, and all this preparation is known as agricultural practice. Okay, even if you are sowing few seeds at your nearby like garden, or your in your kitchen garden, for that also you need to apply these agricultural practices. It's, you know, even you do it, but like you do not know that actually you are following these agricultural practices. Okay, so to begin with, the first word is agricultural practice, and in this, like, what are the steps? Okay, we are going to discuss that. And as we all know, and we have discussed that before preparing a field, before making a field ready, the seeds can't be sown into that, and crops cannot be cultivated. So what we are reading today in this question is like, what is the first step? Okay, or I can say, what are the different steps which has to be taken if you want to have some crops, you want to have some fruits. Fruit in the sense, I'm not talking only about fruits, means the result of that. Okay, so to begin with, the first step is, first of all we need to prepare the soil. Preparation of the soil. Okay, second step is sowing. Third step is manuring. Fourth step is, now see, in all this step you will find like we are preparing the field. Okay, we are preparing the field. See, first of all is preparation of the soil. Means what has to be in the preparation of the soil? Like if you remember, if you have gone through the topic properly, we have to, like, what has to be done? Tilling and leveling has to be done. Okay, so here again, after tilling and leveling, what happens? The soil becomes very loose. It becomes very good for the passage, like the air can pass through it, the water absorbing capacity of the soil get increased. These are the reasons why preparation of the soil has to be done. Then sowing. We all know without sowing the seeds, the crops can't be, like we cannot get any kind of crops, and that is the reason sowing has to be done. After that, manuring. That means manures or the fertilizers are added to the soil. Actually, soil has got all kind of nutrients in it, but still due to repeated cultivation, due to over cultivation, soil get deprived or soil starts lacking such kind of nutrients, and so in addition we need to give manures and fertilizers to the to the crops, or even we need to mix it with the soil. Next is weedicides, like, or we can write protection from weeds. Fifth one is harvesting, and next one is storage. Now we have studied all these processes in quite detail, and we all know that the it's very simple to write all these steps on the blackboard, but it's really difficult to, you know, go through to deal with all such kind of steps, and these steps again have many many parts, okay, and we have discussed, so I won't be going in detail over here. So we have discussed till here protection from weeds. The next step is what? The harvesting. The best thing, the result, the time for the farmers to get result, and again the storage, okay. Now all these things, all these steps are known as agricultural practice, okay. For growing the crops, one has to conduct all these, you know, it has to go, it has to be sequential rather, okay. So these are the steps which needs to be followed. So this was our first keyword, agricultural practice, okay. Now moving to the second one. The second is animal husbandry. Now what is animal husbandry? We have discussed animal husbandry also. Yeah, that's sure that we have not discussed in detail, as it is not there in your syllabus, but still we should know what is the meaning of animal husbandry. To take care, okay, to take care of the animals, taking care of, in which way? To take care of their food, their shelter, their, you know, the place where they live, their even their reproductive processes, like how a better breed can be obtained, okay. All these, like taking care of animals, okay, in order to get some important product from that, maybe the edibles, like whatever, like we may demand, like the demand maybe of the eggs or the honey, whatever, like when the animals, the rearing of animals, okay, the rearing of animals for the purpose of what? For purpose of any, like we can be in need of any kind of thing from the animals. It can be like wool, it can be silk, but rearing of animals for economic purposes and taking care, okay, of their food, their shelter. So this is exactly what we can say is animal husbandry. So just we will write the definition over here. Breeding, caring, and feeding of livestock for any useful product. Okay, or even we can write or rearing of animals for the same. Now see, this just now explain like breeding means like the way of, you know, like even the how to get the better variety of animals, like when we talk about even the cows, how the milk productivity can be increased. Okay, how the productivity of flesh can be increased when we talk about some flesh giving animal, how the quality and the quantity of the eggs can be increased when we talk about egg giving animal. So birds, whatever, even it comes in the category of animals. Okay, so breeding, caring and feeding of livestock for any useful product. The useful product can be anything. It can be silk, it can be wool, it can be egg, it can be flesh, okay, or even or rearing of animals for the same. For the same means what? For the same, like to get, to obtain certain useful product is known as animal husbandry. Okay, now we'll move to the next one. The next one is crop. Now what is the meaning of crop? See, you must be thinking why there is a need of discussion of these keywords. But once if you are thorough with the keywords, you won't be, you know, facing any problem in discussing of objectives. It's not so that all the objectives will be covered in this keywords, but still if you are thorough with the keywords, that means you will be able to solve maximum number of objectives. Okay, now the next is crop. Okay, what is the meaning of crop? Crop means what? When the same kind of plants, okay, are grown, when the same kind of crops are grown or cultivated by men on the, or I can even like on the large scale, in the large scale, on the large scale to obtain, to obtain useful products. Okay, so what is the meaning of crop? When on a piece of land many plants are grown, but of the same type. Okay, when many plants of the same types are grown, then it is known as what? Crop. Okay, and it is grown by whom? Obviously by men. And why it is grown? For the economic purpose, for the useful products. Okay, maybe to obtain certain grains, anything, like whatever, if it is useful for us, that is the reason we are growing it. Okay, so what is crop? Crop is that when the same kind of plants, rather I should write over here, when same kind of plants, okay, please avoid using these crops, when the same kind of plants, I'll rub it rather, when same kind of plants when same kind of plants are grown or cultivated by men on the large scale to obtain useful product. Okay, this is the meaning of crops. Now moving to the next one is fertilizer. I think we have discussed fertilizer in quite detail, okay, but still we have got a keyword over here. And so we are going to discuss what is fertilizer. Fertilizer is what? It is an inorganic compound. What it is? It is an inorganic compound or inorganic chemicals, which is what? Rich in what? It is rich in nitrogen, it is rich in potassium, and it is rich in what? Phosphorus. Okay, so certain inorganic compounds, certain inorganic compounds which are what? Rich in nitrogen, phosphorus. Okay, potassium. Okay, these are added to the soil. For what it is added? To increase the productivity. As you know, I cannot write over here properly, but still, productivity of, to increase the productivity of the soil, or fertility. When you can write fertility over here, okay. So what is the meaning of fertilizer? Certain inorganic compounds. What are these? These are inorganic compounds. Now, what is the meaning of inorganic compounds? Why we are using this word inorganic compound? Because it is not made up of natural things. Okay, when anything is made up of natural thing, then we can say that this is organic compound. Like when we talk about manures are what? They are organic compounds. Organic compounds by, like, why we can say organic compounds? Because they are made from the natural substances, by the dead and decay decomposing substances. The manures are made up of, but here the fertilizers are made up of what? Inorganic compounds, inorganic salts. And these are rich in what? These are rich in nitrogen, phosphorus, or potassium. And it is added to the soil so that the fertility of the soil, so that the fertility, the production capacity of the soil can be increased. Okay, now moving to the next one. Next one is what? Granaries. Okay, it is what? Granaries. Now, what's the meaning of granaries? Actually, when the crop has been harvested, okay, when the crop is being, when the grains are there with the farmers, it cannot be just kept like anywhere, at any place, because even that is dangerous. We have discussed how and why it is dangerous. Okay, so it has to be kept somewhere in a very safe way. So granaries are the place, or like it is like you know, we can say with godowns, where the crops are stored. Okay, where the crops are stored in a safer way, a place where crops are stored in a safer way. Okay, when I say safer way, that means the crops has to be prevented from what? The crops has to be prevented from rodents, okay, insects, moisture, and temperature. Okay, crops has to be protected from all these. We have discussed that stored food need to be protected from biotic as well as abiotic components. Yes, and even the storage can be done in two ways, like dry storage and what, cold storage. Okay, as soon as the crops or the grains are with the, like after harvesting, as soon as the farmers have their grains, can it be stored as it is? Just think and answer. I'll come back to this question after some time. We have this thing in objective, I think so. So please keep, like think and keep. Can farmers immediately, like after cutting the crops, can they store the grains immediately in the godowns? Just give a thought and be ready for the answer. Okay. Meanwhile, we are going to solve the next one. Next one is harvesting. Okay. Next one is what? Harvesting. Now, what's the meaning of harvesting? Harvesting means, what is the meaning of harvesting? It is the best part for the farmers. Yeah. So, cutting off mature crops is known as what? Harvesting. Now, this is, as I told, it is very, very important. Yes, no, harvesting is very important. Like it is a fruit, like result obtaining time for the farmers. Like, so harvesting is what? Cutting of mature crops. It can be done manually. Okay, manually it can be done by what? Manual. It can be done by sickle and some other instruments, which also we are going to discuss. Okay, so I'm not discussing here in detail. And even it can be done with the help of machines. Which machines? Like combine. Yes, so it can be done with the help of, like, with the manually also it can be done, and with the help of machines also it can be done. Okay, moving to the next one. Next is irrigation. Okay, now why irrigation is important and what is irrigation? We have discussed irrigation. Like, see, it's not only irrigation, we know it's what? Giving of supplying water to the crops. But you know, supplying water is very easy. But to supply water at the right time, in right intervals, okay, in right amount, that is irrigation. Irrigation just doesn't mean actually just to supply water. No, not at all. Because we all have studied the supplying water, like untimely supply or oversupply or undersupply of water can give rise to lot of destruction to the crops. This we have all studied. Okay, so now here the next keyword which I am going to take is irrigation.